Hello children, hope you all are well. Today's video is a continuation of video number 1. In our previous video, we learned about the basic concepts, that is point, line and plane. Along with that, we also studied about coordinates of points and how to find the distance between the two given points. So now today we shall learn more about line segment, ray, congruent segments and the properties of congruent segments. So now let us begin. The first one is line segment. Children, you could see I have drawn segment AB. Okay? Now, what is a line segment? The union set of point A, point B and points between A and B is called segment. Now, union set means together. Okay? So, set the points which belongs in this set AB, that is point A and point B. And points between A and B. Now here there are no points. But if there are points in between A and B, then those points also belong to this entire segment. So that is called as segment. So segment is written as seg AB. So this is the way we write this segment. That is seg AB. Now seg AB can be also written as segment BA. Okay, either you can write segment BA or else you can write segment AB. The distance between the endpoints of segment is called the length of the segment. So the distance between point A and point B. So whatever is the distance between point A and point B, that is called as the length of this segment. So that is written as length of segment AB is equals to distance between AB. So this is the way we say that length AB is equals to distance AB. Now next, second is ray. Okay, so now let us see what is ray. You can see I have drawn a ray. Suppose point A and point B are two different points. Okay, then the union set of all points on segment AB is called as ray AB. Now we all know ray means it has one point and at the other end there is a arrow, so that is always called as a ray. Next, line AB. The union set of points on ray AB. Okay, so all the union set of points which belongs to this particular ray AB, okay, that is called as a line. So it is called as line AB. Next, congruent segments. Now, children, you can see I have drawn two segments. One is segment AB, the other one is segment CD. Both the segments are of 5 cm each. Okay, so now I will first see what is the definition of congruent segment. If the length of two segments is equal, then the two segments are congruent. Now the length of two segments, the length means the distance. Okay, so distance AB and distance CD, if the distance are equal, then we say that the two segments are congruent. So AB is 5 cm and CD is 5 cm. So if length AB is equal to length CD, then I can say that segment AB is congruent to segment CD. Okay? Next. We shall now learn the properties of congruent segments. Okay, so now there are three properties of congruent segments. The first property is reflexivity. Now, what is reflexivity? Reflexivity means the segment is congruent to itself. That is called as reflexivity. So, suppose I take segment AB. So, I can see that segment AB is congruent to segment AB itself. Okay? So, that segment is congruent to itself is called as reflexivity. Next, symmetry. Okay? Now, in symmetry, if segment AB is congruent to segment CD, so that means I can say, suppose I assume this is as 1 and I assume this as 2. So if 1 is congruent to 2, then I can say that 2 is congruent to 1. So if AB is congruent to CD, then CD is congruent to AB. Okay? And the last one is transitivity. Now in transitivity, if segment AB is congruent to segment CD, okay, so now segment AB is congruent to segment CD and segment CD is congruent to segment EF. So there is no EF. I draw segment EF. Okay, so this is also 5 cm. Then I can say that segment AB is congruent to segment EF. Okay, that means if 1 is congruent to 2 and 2 is congruent to 3, then I can say that 1 is congruent to 3. So I can say that if AB is congruent to CD and CD is congruent to EF, then segment AB is congruent to segment EF. Okay. Next, comparison of segments. Okay, let us see. Now, you can see I have taken two segments. One is segment AB, the other one is segment CD. So now, if the length of segment AB is less than the length of segment CD. Okay. So, length AB is less than length CD. Then, it is written as segment AB is less than segment CD. Or else, it can be written as segment CD is greater than segment AB. So, either I can write AB is less than CD or CD is greater than AB. Okay. Next, perpendicularity of segments or rays. Now, if the lines containing two segments, two rays, or a ray and a segment are perpendicular to each other, okay, so what it is, if the lines containing two segments, so either AB or CD, or it can be any two rays, or a ray and a segment, okay, if they are perpendicular to each other, if any of those are perpendicular to each other, then the two segments, two rays or a segment and a ray are said to be perpendicular to each other. So if AB and CD, if these two segments are perpendicular to each other, okay, then I can say that AB is perpendicular to CD, okay. So, or else I can say that segment AB is perpendicular to ray CD. So, it can be any of those. And the last one, distance of a point from a line, okay. Distance of a point from a line, if segment AB, okay, and segment CD, okay, you can see AB and CD. So if these two are perpendicular, that means if CD is perpendicular to line AB, that means point D lies on line AB, okay, then this length CD is called the distance of point C from line AB. Okay, I repeat it again. If segment CD is perpendicular to line AB, then this point D lies on line AB. Okay, so length of CD is called the distance. Okay. So, this length CD is called the distance of point C from line AB. Okay, and this point D is called the foot of perpendicular. Now, children, let's see the sixth property. The sixth property is midpoint of segment. Okay. So suppose AB, I have drawn a segment AB and I have taken a midpoint as M. Okay. So now suppose if A dash M dash B, okay, and segment BM is congruent to segment AM, then I can say that M is called the midpoint of segment AB. Okay, so if A dash M dash B means if M is a midpoint, okay, that means segment AM and segment BM both are congruent, then I can say that this point M is the midpoint of segment AB. Now, always remember every segment has only one and one midpoint. Okay. Now, children, let us go to practice set exercise 1.2. Children, now open your textbook to page number 7, practice set 1.2. Question number 1. The following table shows the points on a number line and their coordinates. Decide whether the pair of the segments given below the table are congruent or not. So they have shown us the table which has a point and coordinates, and below that they have given us a pair of segments. So using the table we have to find whether the following pair of the segments are congruent or not. So now let us start with the solution. Segment DE and segment AB. First one. Now let us see which are the coordinates of segment DE and segment AB. So coordinate of point D is negative 7 and coordinate of point E is 9. So first I write the coordinate of point D is negative 7 and the coordinate of point E is 9. Next, we have to compare both the numbers, negative 7 and positive 9. So we all know positive number is greater than negative number. So 9 is greater than negative 7. So I will write the formula. Distance between DE is equal to greater coordinate minus the smaller coordinate. So here the greater coordinate is 9 minus the smaller coordinate is negative 7. So negative 7 I write in bracket because there are two negative signs which comes together. So now minus and minus gives you plus. So 9 plus 7 is equals to 16. So length of distance EE is equal to 16 units. That is equation 1. Next, we have to find the coordinates of point A and point B. So now let us see the coordinate of point A. Coordinate of point A is negative 3 and coordinate of point B is 5. So write coordinate of point A is negative 3 and here the coordinate of point B is 5. So next step we'll compare 5 and negative 3. So we know 5 is greater than negative 3. Okay? So again I'm going to use the formula. Distance AB is equals to greater coordinate minus smaller coordinate. The greater coordinate is 5 minus the smaller coordinate is negative 3. So 5 minus of minus 3, which is equals to 5 plus 3 minus minus becomes plus. So that is equals to 8. So distance AB is equals to 8 units. Therefore length AB is equals to 8 units. So now I write this as equation 2. Now comparing equation 1 and equation 2. Now here equation 1, the length DE is equal to 16 units. And in equation 2, length AB is 8 units. And we have to find whether the two segments which are given are congruent or not. So here 16 and 8, both are different numbers, so they are not equal. So I can say that from 1 and 2, length DE is not equal to length AB. So segment DE is not congruent to segment AB. Okay? I hope so. You all have followed the sum. Now, let's see the next sum. Question 2. Point M is the midpoint of segment AB. Okay, they have said that point M is the midpoint of segment AB. If AB is 8, then find length AM. Okay, now let us see the solution. What they have given? Point M They have given us that point M is midpoint of segment AB. So you can see segment AB over here. Okay. And point M is a midpoint. So since M is a midpoint, I can say that AM and MB both are divided into two equal halves. Okay. So AM and MB are divided into two equal halves because point M is a midpoint. So I can write that as length AM is half of length AB. Okay, I can write that as length AM is half of length AB. So next, length AM is half of length AB. Now we know they have given us length AB. This length AB is 8. They have given us the length AB is 8. and we have to find length AM. So if length AB is 8, I will write length AB as 8, that is half into 8. So next, 2 1s are 2, 2 4s are 8. So I can say that length AM is equals to 4 units. So I got the answer, length AM is equals to 4 units. Okay. Next, question number 3. Children, the question number 3 is for homework. It is same like second question. Okay, so I want you all to solve for your homework. Now let us proceed further to question number 4. If AB is 5 cm, BP is 2 cm and AP is 3.4 cm, compare the segments. Okay, it is compare the segments. Compare means you have to say which is a greater segment and which is the smaller segment. So now let us see the exercise solution. AB is 5 cm, BP is 2 cm and AP is 3.4 cm. The three measurements are given to us. Now, I will first see which is the greatest among all three. So I can say 5 is the greater number. Okay. Then after 5 comes 3.4 and after 3.4 the list is 2. So I write that as 5 is greater than 3.4 and 3.4 is greater than 2. Okay. Now 5. 5 is length AB. So I can write length AB in place of 5. I write length AB is greater than. Now 3.4 is length AP. So it's greater than length AP. And 2 is length BP. So is greater than length BP. Next, therefore, segment AB is greater than segment AP, is greater than segment BP. Okay, this is the answer. Next, question number 5. Page 8. Question 5. Write the answers of the following questions with reference to the figure 1.13. Okay. So they have given us the figure. Okay. Now first, write the name of the opposite ray of ray RP. Now we will see where is ray RP. Ray RP. This is ray RP. Right. So now I have to write the name of the opposite ray. Okay, opposite means which is in the opposite side. Okay, so I will see now ray RP. So it begins from point R and goes to P. Okay, so I will see which is the opposite ray to RP. So the opposite ray to ray RP is ray RS. Okay, and ray RT. Okay, so the first answer is ray RS and ray RT. So I can say that ray RS or ray RT is opposite to ray RP. Okay. Now next, the second one, write the intersection set of ray PQ, okay, ray PQ and ray RP, okay, intersection of ray PQ and ray RP. So I have to see which is the intersection set. So the intersection set of ray PQ and ray RP is ray PQ. Children, you all have studied intersection and union in your algebra lesson 1. Okay, so I'm not going to explain you again. So the intersection of the intersection set of ray PQ and ray RP is ray PQ. That is the second answer. Okay, so the intersection set of ray PQ and ray RP is ray PQ itself. Next. Okay, children, now let us see the third sum. Write the union set of ray PQ and ray QR. Ray PQ and, okay, this is ray PQ and ray QR. Now, here in your textbook it is given as segment. Cancel that segment and write ray. Okay, in both the places you cancel seg and write ray. So we have to find the union set of ray PQ and ray QR. So the union set of ray PQ and ray QR is this entire line QR, because a line segment consists of all the points. Okay, and that is why we call that as line QR. So the union set, union means the total. Okay, it consists of all the elements. So the union of point of ray PQ and ray QR is line QR. So you can see the union of ray PQ and ray QR is line QR. Okay, now next, fourth question. Question 4. State the rays of which sec QR is a subset. Okay, you have to write the rays of which sec QR is a subset. Subset means those rays are the part of this segment QR. Okay, so I can say that as segment. Okay, so I can say that as ray QR, okay, and ray RQ. Okay, ray QR and ray RQ are subset of segment QR. Okay, so I write that as segment QR is a subset of ray QR and ray RQ. Next, fifth question. Write the pair of opposite rays with endpoint R. Okay, so you have to write the pair of opposite rays with common endpoint as R. So common endpoints should be R. So I will see which are the rays which I can write with common endpoint as R. So I can write as ray RP and ray RS. Okay, you can write any one pair. So I have written ray RS and ray RP. You can also write as ray RT and ray RQ, but it should have R as the point. Okay, so I have written ray RP and ray RS. Next, sixth question. Write any two rays with common endpoint as S. Okay, so you have to write any two rays which has common endpoint as S. So I can write as ray ST and ray SR. Okay, so I have written ray ST and ray SR. The last question. Write the intersection set of ray SP and ray ST. So you have to write the intersection of two rays. One is the ray SP and the other one is the ray ST. Earlier in third one, it was a union. Okay? Here it is the intersection of ray SP and ray ST. So, I write that as the intersection of ray ST and ray SP is point S. Okay? It is point S. Okay? I hope so you all have followed this sum. Okay, you can see I have written the intersection of ray SP and ray ST is point S. Okay, now let us go to next question, question number 6. Answer the following questions with the help of the figure 1.14. You can see a number line is shown. Okay, you can see there is a number line given to you. Okay, and you have to answer the following question. Now children, please make a note that question 3 in your exercise 1.2, question 6, sub question 3. Okay, this question has been omitted. Okay, so just cancel sub question 3 from question number 6. So now we will see the solution of question number 1 and 2. So first question. State the point which are equidistant from point B. Okay. Now you can see a number line is given. And along with that they have given you the coordinates of each point. And we have to find first question. State the points which are equidistant from point B. So now let us see where is point B. This is my point B. So I have to find the points which are equidistant. Now the coordinate of point B is 2. Now if I see the difference between point A and point B. The coordinate of point A is 0 and the coordinate of point B is 2. So if you see the difference between 0 and 2, the difference is of two numbers. Okay. So 0 to 2, the difference is two numbers. Now, I will see the coordinate of point B and point C. The coordinate of point B is 2 and the coordinate of point C is 4. So, even here, 2 and after 2 directly it is 4. So, if you see the difference is of two numbers. How you find the difference? The difference is how you find it? You will find by subtracting 4. You will find it by subtracting 2 from 4. So that becomes 4 minus 2. So the difference is of two numbers. Okay. So if you see. Now if you see the coordinate of point D and point B. The coordinate of point B is 2. And the coordinate of point D is 6. So if you subtract 2 from 6, you get it as 4. So that is not possible. Okay. I have to find which are equidistant. So the coordinates which are equidistant from point B are 0 and 4. So the points which are equidistant are point A and point C because both are at a distance of 2 units each. So from 0 to 2 it is 2 units and from 2 to 4 again it is 2 units. So point A and point C are the two points which are equidistant from point B. So I write the answer as point A and point C. Okay. Next. Second one. Okay children, so we got the first pair of points as point A and point C which are equidistant from point B, and the second pair of points are point P and point D. Okay, you're going to solve in a similar way. So you will get point P and point D also equidistant from point B. Next, second question. Write the pair of points equidistant from point Q. Now this is my point Q. Okay. So I have to find the pair of points which are at equal distance from point Q. Okay, so I will see which are the points at equal distance. Now minus, now the coordinate at point Q is negative 4 and the coordinate at point R is negative 6. So I can write minus 4 minus of minus 6. Okay, so that is minus 4 plus 6, which is equals to minus and plus gives me minus, and 6 minus 4 gives me plus 2 because 6 has a positive sign. So the distance between point Q and point R is 2 units. Similarly, you will find the distance between point Q and point P. So now point Q is negative 4 and point P is negative 2. So first I write negative 2, that is greater coordinate, minus the smaller coordinate, that is equals to minus 2, minus minus gives you plus 4, that is equals to 2 units. So you got distance RQ and QP equal. Okay, so if we get distance RQ and distance QP equal, I can say that point R and point P are equidistant from point Q. Okay, so I write point R and point P are equidistant from point Q. Okay, this is the second answer. Okay, children, I already informed that the third question, which is there, okay, from question number 6, is been omitted. Okay. Now, okay, I have given you the homework. Okay, you have to solve the homework in your notebook itself. Okay, where you are going to solve the problems which I have already solved in the video. And please make a note of the sums which have been omitted in this lesson. Okay, I have made a list of the entire problems which have been omitted in the entire lesson and the problem set. Okay, so children, please do the homework. Okay. Thank you.